surviving in Chicago can be extremely difficult, especially if you're a public monument or artwork. As of last count, there are over 700 of them scattered throughout Chicago. At least half of them are located on Chicago Park District property. This year, 2017, has been coined the year of public art in Chicago by our mayor, Rahm Emanuel, so this number is ever growing. Whilst being in public spaces can bring interest and value to an area, it also exposes them to vandalism and ambitious opportunists. Some of the stories surrounding Chicago's public monuments are incredible and even hard to believe. Chicago's oldest monuments are commemorative and cast out of bronze. They were generally erected during times of prosperity, but during times of poverty and struggle, the bronze statues were seen as targets for a quick buck to be made off the somewhat precious metal. Rarely is a statue stolen for its aesthetics, but it does happen, and you'll find out soon enough. The Alarm, 1884, by John Boyle. It depicts a life-size American Indian family as they all seem to be alert to some pending danger. The sculpture's benefactor was Martin Rayerson, who traded with the Indians over the lake in Michigan. He dedicated the sculpture to them. Although hard to see, it reads, "To the Ottawa Nation of Indians, my early friends." It's a great message of friendship and acceptance, which is kind of rare to see now. There are four granite tablets on the base depicting the peace pipe, the corn dance, forestry, and the hunt. These used to be cast in bronze, but they were pried off and stolen. Stealing bronze plaques is quite common. Usually thieves take what they can pry off and carry away, like the dog's tail, which has been lopped off on this sculpture. General John Logan Memorial, 1897. It was created by Augustus Saint-Gaudens and Alexander Fimister. It commemorates the war general and Illinois state senator. It's pretty much intact, except he's missing his sword, which has been stolen so many times that they haven't bothered replacing it. It's also missing his right boot spur. While hacking off parts of bronze monuments has proved popular, some have disappeared altogether. Where I'm standing in this general area was a bust of Beethoven. It was constructed in 1897 and disappeared in 1971. All the police could find was a leftover rope. There's meant to be part of the monument still here, but I can't find it, so it may or may not still be around. Emanuel Swedenborg Monument, 1924 by Adolf Johnson. Although he stands today, it's been a tough ride for the Swedish scientist and philosopher. After 52 years here, in 1976, the bust was stolen. They replaced it with a pyramid so that the monument could look more monumenty. In 2009, some genius driver going up Lakeshore Drive managed to crash into the monument. They replaced it in 2012 with a bust made from the original mold. Fountain Girl, 1893 by George Wade. It was made for the World Columbian Exhibition. It was eventually moved to Lincoln Park in 1921, and in 1958, it was stolen, completely gone, and was never recovered. Three identical statues exist. The closest was in Portland. In 2007, Lincoln Park resident and philanthropist worked with a series of donors and the park district to recreate the statue from a mold taken from the one in Portland. In 2012, the new Fountain Girl now stands again upon its original granite base here in Lincoln Park. The World's Fair Bulls with Maidens, 1893 by Daniel French and Edward Potter. Much like the Art Institute lions, these two came from the World Columbian Exhibition. They were originally plaster casts and they proved so popular that they decided to cast them in bronze, and they eventually ended up right here at Garfield Park. Both of the bulls weigh a ton and they are bolted to these giant granite slabs. So you can imagine the surprise when someone walked by and noticed that this bull behind me was missing. The other statue, the bull had its tail removed and the maiden was missing an arm. This was in the 1980s, and they still don't know who did it. The Chicago Park District commissioned a new bull to be made, and it now stands behind me. They also repaired its partner. This is where the story gets even more crazy. In 2010, the Chicago Park District received an email from an auction house asking if they were missing a bull. It was discovered in Virginia at an estate sale, and apparently the deceased owner was the third one to own the statue, since it was stolen in the 80s, so the trail back to the original cellar was long forgotten. It was returned to Chicago in need of repairs, and it now sits in storage, waiting, maybe for someone to steal its younger replacement. There's also an interesting story behind this sculpture. If you know it, write it in the comments. If not, I'll put an article in the description so you can read up about it. It's pretty hilarious.